Or not log in, but just like view on Twitter.
It should be, you should be able to see it now.
There it is, live from Evo.
You got it?
Yeah, there it is. Great, the lower third's there, so it doesn't make me... Huh? The lower third's there, so it doesn't make me look so fat.
Can you see? The money. We're back. Hey, look at us. We're back in the studio.
You're too excited.
I am excited, man. It's been over almost 2 years.
We're like friends, but better.
We are. We're rebooting. You know, friends stay the test of time. We stay the test of time.
Look who it is. There's a British guy on Periscope.
Is there a British guy?
I thought we lost you in the harbor with all the tea we dumped. Anyways,
Are we gonna be racist already?
That's not racist. Again. He's English, okay? There's a difference.
Oh, he's English, that's okay.
Yeah, it's okay.
Hey, we've upgraded in case you can't tell. You might actually be able to see us now. One of us has gained a little bit more weight. Not much.
I don't know what you're talking about.
That might be me.
I just had to fit into the Otis jacket.
Did Otis drop that off for you?
No, I made it myself.
You made it yourself.
No, Walmart. Made it.
Walmart made it? Okay, I was getting ready to say. Anyway, yeah, we're back. Of course, we got a better camera. We're not using the iPad anymore, so it's really nice. We actually, you should be able to hear us now. There's many times you couldn't hear us back in the day. So candlelight, you know, if you're listening, you should be able to listen now.
Yeah.
Usually you didn't listen anyway, but hey.
Yeah. Now you can hear me make fun of you. And your English accent. Because every time you talk, I just go, pip, pip, cheerio, well, look at this, who is this? You know.
Please do your Paige accent.
No.
Come on, man. Just one time.
Look, I don't have a problem with Paige. She just sounds like Mary Poppins.
Oh, I thought you were going to say Robin Williams.
No.
Mrs. Doubtfire.
No.
That's what you sound like. You don't sound like...
Oh, my name is Paige. Is that what you're talking about? I have the title. It's time for tea and crumpets. I mean, I don't know what you want me to say.
Nah, you good. So we're back. Wrestling Attitude, of course, back on your channels. We are live on Periscope, Twitter. We will put it on YouTube later. I will also put it on Spreaker.com so you can get it from those platforms. Oh my God, what?
Nothing.
Not yet.
Coming from Otis' bigger cousin. Well, yeah. I mean, I feel like I'm Otis. I feel like James, he needs to be a little taller. He could be Tucker.
No, I got more attitude than Tucker, man.
Nah, you're Tucker. Tucky! Come on. It works, man. You can be Tucker.
Tucker is so boring.
Come on.
Put him to sleep, man.
No. I like Tucker. They're just not letting him talk, man.
Poor guy. He's getting overshadowed because he can't talk.
No, I don't think it's that. I think just, I think Otis has that charisma in him, and he's just funny. He's a funny fat guy. Take it from another funny fat guy.
Oh, wait a minute. You
make a fat guy dance on live TV, people go, that's so great, okay? It's just, he's funny.
Big Dick Johnson dance on TV. I don't see people cheering for him the way they did Otis.
Well, he went back to, Ohio Valley Wrestling, so he didn't pan out.
Ohio Valley Wrestling.
Yeah, isn't that what it's called?
Yes. It was back in the day. 1994.
1994. Yes, because that's when he was there. Yes.
So anyway, we are currently at our new location, our new school. We haven't actually done a new show from here.
Wait, this is new?
Well, it's newer for the listeners, yes.
Oh, no, I thought we'd been at the same place for the last 2 years. What is this? Where are we?
This is a new campus that we're at. We're doing the show at the Connecticut School of Broadcasting, where you can work to make your dreams come true.
Is that the same?
Mm-hmm. So. And, of course, the show is sponsored by Attitude Broadcasting. Mm-hmm. We put Attitude in broadcasting. Or we
in
put
broadcasting.
Lot, or oh. we put a lot of cookies. I mean, you know, one way or another.
We don't put cookies in it. We eat the cookies. There's a difference.
Somebody here eats the cookies.
Yep. We should have a cookie jar. We should get a wrestling cookie jar. Ooh, that's perfect. Every time I make a good take, I get a cookie. That's how it works. It'd be perfect. It'd be perfect.
Don't worry, you'll never get a cookie.
It says you. We'll leave it up to Mr. Candlelight. Wait, let's not leave it up to Mr. Candlelight. He won't let me get a cookie. So
he doesn't. In his country, it's called biscuits.
What were you about to say? Because you weren't making the...
No, I was like, going to say cricket.
You were going to say cricket?
Not crickets, but...
Cricket is what they play over there. They don't eat the crickets.
No, I know that. They play squash.
Well, yeah, I mean, we call it ball bouncing on a brick here, but...
ball bouncing on a brick?
Ball bouncing on a wall, okay? That's what we call it.
Handball?
Yeah. It's handball. Racquetball, yeah, okay? That's what we call it. It's called racquetball.
In case you don't notice, I have missed Little Steven. Okay. All right, first of all, we got to figure this out. Do we call you Little Steven anymore? I mean, you're not so little as you used to.
No, but, I mean, I don't want to go with my brand at the radio station. So, my brand at the radio station. Why not?
You
got a problem with Hacksaw?
There's one Hacksaw, all right?
Yeah, it's Hacksaw Helbig.
No, it's... Hacksaw Duggan.
No, Hacksaw Helbig, okay?
What have you ever hacksaw?
A lot more than Hacksaw.
Well, I don't know. How many 2x4s have you ever carried in your life?
All right, first off, let's be honest here. We've gone to a few things where Hacksaw's shown up, and we've gotten pictures and stuff like that. Now, this man is selling a 2x4 that's this big.
It's a 2x4.
That's not a 2x4. That's like
it's
a 2x2. Okay?
It was a 2x2. So what?
I'm not buying a 2x2 for $15 when I could get a picture for $5. $5 when he went to the local Lowe's and got the wood.
Should we tell everybody the story when you actually called him something else? You called
what
him
did
Steve.
I call
him? You said Steve or something. I can't remember.
Don't remember saying that. But all I remember is I've had, like, many conversations with him. But, yeah, I know you can't call me little anymore. I'm fat. I was never little. Little even when I was here. I was always fat.
Big boned. In America, we say big boned.
Yeah, over there you guys call us fat or tubby. Tubby. Which I think is an English word, isn't it?
Tubby's an English word.
He's going to be my English translator. Everything I say.
Thank God somebody's your
English. I want him to say it in English.
In English?
Yeah, not American. English.
Do you know we're talking English, right?
No, we're talking American. See? I can be Hacksaw. Anyways, no, see, so. What?
No, go ahead. So what? Go ahead.
No, but, I mean, with Hacksaw, he's just. He's out there, man. He's just.
Well, he's also. He's 108 years old.
Hacksaw, if you're listening, because you're not, but...
he might be. You can listen to us live.
Great. Great on your recovery, by the way, because he's doing great.
Recovery of what?
Well, he just had that recovery where he had the heart surgery actually less than a year ago. He had heart surgery, yes. And now he's back on tour doing stuff. So he's guess
he's
what he's doing?
Tour.
He's doing the Mick Foley route, and he's at the Comedy Zone.
Oh man, I got to listen to comedy he does.
I don't think it's comedy. I think it's just him telling stories.
Oh, which would be comedy?
I guess for him that's comedy.
I mean, Mick Foley is about him and Hacksaw are about the
same. Yeah, but Foley's funny though. Like Foley has a way where he can make a joke about something because. It's an inside joke, but we're all wrestling fans, so we find it funny. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Hacksaw just blabbers.
Kind of like you.
Yes, so that's why I'm Hacksaw. So, boom. That's the origin of Hacksaw.
That's the origin of Hacksaw. Yeah. That's terrific. That's a great story. I mean, we've missed your stories. I know Ken Light has not had a great life without your stories. I have.
You're right, Mr. Candlelight. At least we don't have to see James's feet anymore. You're totally
feet?
Right.
What's wrong with my feet? I got some sexy feet.
I wouldn't tell people that.
Shawn Michaels, that's what the song was about.
Sexy yeah, it feet. Was about his feet. You're
no,
right.
It was
totally
about
his feet.
About my feet.
I don't think he wants that. You were like a kid at the time, probably.
I was like a kid. You remember, I'm the older one in this group.
Are you?
Yeah. So, anyway, before we get kicked off the network.
We'll never get kicked off the network.
Hey, Bobby Reed, there you go. Anyway, we're back to our show today. The show today, we're going to talk about a lot of different things, but we have been mentioned about Fast 9, if you don't know what it is, Fast and Furious 9. I don't know what the relation
Fast
is.
Fast 9?
So, somebody at Fast 9 tagged us into WWE show, which I'm fine with. So, when you go watch Fast and Furious, you can also listen to Wrestling Attitude Show.
What is this with these Twitter handles just putting us in their tag? Like, this is the first time this has happened.
No, this isn't the first time this has happened. This isn't. You know how many other times this happened? It's happened for, what is it in Las Vegas they have every year?
The World Window Association.
The World Window Association, where they with pools and all this other stuff. I'm like, we're not there. But if you want to tag us, go ahead.
Oh, I would have lied. I would be like, come on, see our booth.
You look like you work at
the organization. I would have literally got a ticket, went to Las Vegas, said, yes, we're WWA. We're on the Twitter page. We're on the Twitter page. Boom. I would have got us in. We would have been fine.
True, it's a WWE show. But we also are going to talk about, we're going to talk about the first segment, we're going to talk about the Hall of Fame. And then the next segment, you know, we'll talk a little bit of a review of the Rumble and different things. The Porter John that Corbin went in.
The Porter John. Yeah. Oh.
Goldberg's going to be on SmackDown, NWA Power. You know, I know Steven loves
it. Yeah, I can't wait for the Goldberg. That's going to be great. We'll get there, though. Yeah, stay
definitely
tuned.
Definitely. Yeah, but we got a lot of great things to talk
we
about.
We do. I mean, the Rumble just happened, which I'm still kind of happy about. I liked it. I know we'll get into it here in a minute, but overall, I wasn't it wasn't the worst Rumble. I think the winner was great. I know we'll get into all that, but, I mean, you and I talked about this. I think it was it was better than what it could have been of what we thought was going to happen. So, you know, especially the ending. I thought the later on in the match was great in the men's Royal Rumble. I thought was good. The women's Royal Rumble wasn't bad. I mean, it was okay. But, I mean, the show overall I thought was good, and I thought it was good lead into the new year for pay-per-views. I thought it was an okay pay-per-view.
I thought it was very good, and we'll definitely get into it. I definitely won't talk about a lot of that stuff, but first,
No, Mr. Candlelight. Today I'm not sure. I don't really have a top five. I mean, if we think of one, maybe.
If you want to talk about one,
yeah,
maybe.
Like if you give us an idea, we'll do one right now.
Our thought we was gonna do a top five next week.
Yeah,
top five returns since Edge came back. But you want to? We got plenty
top
of time.
Top five for returns. Whew. Now that I want to say that one for next week because that's going to be a good one. Yeah,
that's going to be next week.
Yeah, like, I mean, if you want to like top five British wrestlers of all time, all right, British Bulldog, British Bulldog, British Bulldog, British Bulldog, and oh yeah, British Bulldog. That's all you're getting.
Really, William Regal?
Okay, well, all right, William Regal or Steven Regal, which one was better? I'm basically asking, was WCW Regal better or was he's a man? Which one was better?
Well, before we do that, we can talk about that. Let's go into our little segment we're going to do. State of Wrestling.
Oh.
State of...
I don't know.
It's funny. There we go. State of the Wrestling Union Address.
Where the hell are we?
We're in the great United States. This is not DX's State of Union Address.
No, it's not 1997.
It's not 97. So, in case you haven't been watching the latest wrestling that's going on, some bad, some good. Let's talk about the bad. Lana and Liv, what the hell are you doing? Seriously. What is that? Bioni?
Yeah.
I didn't want to say Bologna. So, bologna.
I didn't know you were offended by bologna, but okay.
Whatever. No, I love fried bologna. But that is one of my State of the Unions. It's the state of wrestling right now.
Oh, is the music?
With some of the... Oh, it should be still playing. It's a long song, dude. Relax. Oh, 57 seconds. What kind of song did I download?
I know which one he did. I don't know what to say, man. I thought they... You know what I think? Why we don't like it? Because the Bobby Lashley and Lana thing is so drawn out. It was so dumb. And it could have been good, but you were trying to capitalize on something that we've seen constant every... Like, we've seen so many times in WWE. In the last 20 years, we've seen this whole, oh no, two people break up, and then they get the, and we see a divorce on TV, and then we see a marriage. Like, it's so stupid. It's been done so many times. And Liv Morgan was not going to make it better. Unfortunately. So, yeah.
Well, it's horrible, but I don't understand. Not just that.
Beyonce's not a new word, Mr. Candlelight. Beyonce is not. Technically, he's saying it the way it should be because you said Beyonce's. Beyonce. Okay.
Beyonce.
No, he just put Beyonce. So Beyonce, new word. New word now.
I told you. Beyonce. Listen, every show I create new words. This is my summit lingo. It's what happens.
I really
it's at the top of the summit. This is what we're going with.
At some point, we're going to make that a segment. The summit lingo.
No, it should be.
Every week.
We definitely do that. All right. But it's not just WWE's got some bad issues. AEW. Listen, I'm loving some of it. But then, what in the blue hell is some of this crap that they're doing? Marco Stunt. The guy is 2 foot 2 inches. Okay? And then Sonya Kiss or whatever that thing is. Yeah, the one with the... That looks like a Demolition Man back in 1989's Wesley Snipes with the booty.
Sonya Kiss?
Yes, Kiss something AEW. But there's some horrible segments going. There's horrible stuff going on in the wrestling community, the world. I'm trying to think of another bad AEW segment that's killing me. Excalibur. Listen, do we need a third man on that booth?
You mean Sonny Kiss?
That's it, Sonny Kiss.
Oh, well, that's something different. I don't really want to talk about that.
No, I don't. It's just awesome. And I'm the rehashing of storylines is like, listen, I like some AEW, but it's like WCW all over again. And I get it. No, I don't. Because you're supposed to be a revolution. You know, be a revolution. Be different.
I'm gonna counteract you on one thing. I like Marco Stunt. I get it. He's small. He's different. But I love the whole the Jurassic Express or Jurassic Express.
You know, that's one of the good things I like. I like that. I like it. Best Friends. I love Orange Cassidy. I love what they're doing with that. It's so different. And that's the good stuff. I really enjoy it. I enjoy that. I like what they're doing with Sammy Guevara.
I'd rather watch James Ellsworth be a freaking champion.
No, can I tell you how much I'm so glad we don't have James Ellsworth in my life anymore?
Now we got
it's amazing.
Now we got Orange Cassidy.
Orange Cassidy at least is.
Yeah, let me do a kick. Here, watch everybody. You can't see it, but here's my kick. That was me kicking. I didn't do anything.
And stop saying how much better their tag team wrestling is compared to everybody else. They got some good tag teams, but they got some stuff like Private Party is basically Street Profits. What?
So, Mr. Candlelight says it's the same with Corbin versus Reigns and Rey Mysterio going for the U.S. title, just why. I agree with you.
No, it is.
So, the first time Rey went for the title, cool. I was okay with it. Now it's starting to get redundant. Now, I will say one thing because we'll get into it when we review a little bit of Raw. I'm kind of liking what they're doing, though, with the U.S. title of doing it more luchador style. I like the storylines.
About the storylines with that stuff, you know, of course, Mrs. Flair got suspended for 30 days. So it's nice to see Rey Mysterio train these younger guys.
Yeah.
And that's what I like to see. Humberto Carrillo is, you know, him. And now Angel Garza.
on Raw. Yeah. Angel Garza is really
I'd
good.
I'd like to see Ricochet in the mix, though. I know they're pushing Ricochet, which is great.
Ricochet
like
is a lot better than that.
I know. Well, no, not that. I'd like to see it because of the high flying and the luchador and stuff. I think it would match, is what I'm saying. Not saying to put him completely in the storyline, but, you know, let him have a match with him once or twice, you know? You can cross the storylines a little bit. That's fine. We do it. They do it all the time in wrestling. I don't see the problem with that.
But then we got other, you know, NXT's doing pretty well. I like most of what they're doing there in NXT. SmackDown. Listen, if I see another freaking dog can, all right, I'm done with the dog food angle.
By the way.
Can we move on?
Are you guys just like, I mean, like, I get you guys work with Walmart and all that. Can you get better dog food than Old Roy? Every week, it's just Old Roy. There's other dog food out there. All right?
Yeah, you discriminate against other dog food.
And also, WWE's really cheap because Old Roy is like, I could get like, you know, I could give you $10 and probably get like 2,000 cans of Old Roy. Okay?
But why aren't you going to use expensive dog food?
Why not? He's the king. So he's King Corbin, so he should get like the expensive stuff, right? Like Beneful or something. Like the ones that come in the... Yeah, why not? I'm just saying, I don't understand. I think... You know, instead of getting the 97-cent one, let's get the one that costs $2, you know? Come on.
I see what you're saying. But we also got some other things like SmackDown. You know, Otis thing's fine with me. You got Goldberg is going to be on SmackDown Friday. We'll talk about that. NWA Power.
Mm-hmm.
I like some of that. Here's the thing. All right. Poor Eli Drake. God's got a lot, and he's there. Aldis is there. Of course, Aaron Stevens is there. You know, they got a good tag team. I like this. You know, I haven't really watched much of it. You're more with that.
Yeah.
It's in Atlanta, so it's doing the old school NWA thing, which is cool. James Storm, Eli Drake. I mean, James Storm, really? I mean, Melina?
Mm-hmm.
Melina?
Yeah, yeah. So, we do have a question on Periscope, but before we get to that, I did want to say one thing, though. My closing statement with this whole thing it would be, I mean, I know that there are some rough parts of both AEW, WWE, and NWA Power, but one thing I would like to say, especially since October, since all this went down, since AEW became... on TV, NXT on TV, NWA becoming a thing again. I really, really like wrestling right now. I just think like there's a lot of options, and I think it's great. It's not as stale. A lot of storylines that are being rehashed, but I think it's a lot better than it was a few years ago. I think we're reamping wrestling here.
Oh,
and I like it.
AEW and NXT is definitely helping that.
Yes.
Let me say that. They're really helping that as far as making it better for the future and where it's going.
That's true. Mr. Candlelight says, WTF with all the 30 wellness policy hand-me-outs. I kind of agree with you. I don't know what's going on backstage because I haven't really read into it because it doesn't make sense about the wrestlers that are getting the 30-day wellness policies. I don't know what they're taking. There must be some drug that they're taking that they're not allowing now. That I bet it's not steroids or any of those performance-enhancing drugs, but I bet there must be some change to the wellness policy that they're not telling the wrestlers or something. I don't know. Because he is right. We've seen a lot lately. We have seen a lot lately, and I don't know what's going on.
No, there has been a lot. And supposedly the rumor was going to be Samoa Joe failed a drug test.
Oh my god.
Supposedly, but he did not. There was supposed to be another one I read today. Besides Andre, it's got to be some, like you were saying, some performance enhancing, you know, like a vitamin or over the counter or something.
That's what I'm saying. It's got to be something that they're seen as a performance enhancing drug. Also, Mr. Candlelight says it's been 2 years and the Summit has to mention Damian Sandow again. Let it go, man.
I said Aaron Stevens. I didn't say Damian Sandow.
But he knew who you were talking
about. Just wait until we get to the Hall of Fame. There's somebody else I'm going to be talking about.
He's not. No. Oh, my God. Alright, yeah. Move on.
You know the greatest thing on TV? Let me go ahead and address the elephant in the room while I'm closing statements here, is what I was told.
It is. It's closing statements.
The best show on TV has to be the weekly show they do on Fox at night. That is Renee Young, Booker T, and who else is the third? Christian.
CM Punk?
Too.
Yeah,
no, it's
saying.
A very good show.
Wow, you're going to overshadow CM Punk with Christian. How dare you?
Well, hey, he started it. But no, it's been, I throw him in there once in a while. I don't stay on him too long.
Yeah, I mean, can we talk about the show for a second here? The one they have on Fox, the Backstage?
Backstage, yeah, go ahead.
I think it's great. I get it, all the marks and everybody talking about CM Punk's back. Look, guys, it's great. It's in the right direction for CM Punk, but slow down. Mm-hmm. All right? Let things go. Like, yes, a year or two ago, we might not have ever said CM Punk is back working with the company. He's not working in the company. He's working with the company. He's on Fox. He is not an employee of WWE. He is working with WWE. There's a difference. But with that being said, this is still great. This is still a good door. I don't think the door is completely closed. I think it's halfway open. But now we just have to see what happens. I think CM Punk will eventually come back, but I don't think it's anytime soon.
We'll see. I think it's going to be quicker than you think. Maybe. But at least he's there.
Yeah.
You know, it's just great to see him backstage. And
well, that
talking.
He's able, yeah. And he's talking with people, yeah.
You know, and him, and you know, down the line, we'll see what happens. But never say never, just stuff.
Mr. Carolyn says, yes, James, take Steven's advice as well. Let it go. He's talking about Sandow. Or is he talking about CM Punk? He could be talking about both. I don't understand his British ways. So...
his British ways.
Yeah, his British ways.
What is his British ways? I mean,
I don't know.
I'm so want to know.
But anyways, yeah. So is that your State of the Union there? Was that all you wanted it to be, huh? Was that great?
That was good.
Yeah?
That was good start and
segment. They can't hear this. I don't need to hear this.
You sure? I mean, you keep telling me to let it go.
I don't...
I mean, do you want me to play more of that?
No. Okay, Mr. Candlelight can't hear it, but he's playing Let It Go, the Frozen. The Frozen song.
What do you mean he can't hear it?
Can he hear it? I don't know.
He
can
should be able to.
Yeah? How's he able to hear it? Is it connected to the board? Oh, there you go.
There you go. You feel better now? I let it go. All right. So back to our show.
Mighty Molly!
That was we'll talk about that.
Oh, was it great? Yeah, you were calling her Molly the whole time. Not Mighty Molly, which she came out as. She's not Molly Holly.
So, all right, let's get back to the show.
Don't tempt him. Don't tempt him.
He wants to play again?
No, that's not what he wants. I'm not letting you derail the show, Mr. Candlelight.
So... let's get into any other news we got going on. Do we want to talk about the Hall of Fame right now?
You want to go over the Rumble real quick, or do you want to do that? It's up to you.
We can go over the Rumble. We just going to say that for the next segment. We can go ahead and talk about the Rumble if you want. Go ahead.
So do you.
Start.
Well, I mean, do you want to go... as you can see... Well, people on Periscope can see... People listening, we've been talking about a little bit about what's been going on, and the Royal Rumble just happened, and about 2 weeks ago, and you know they had their opening match. I don't know, man. The whole Roman Reigns.
The Roman Reigns. They had to put it into it.
But they didn't really, because then you know they did SmackDown not that long ago, and then they poured dog food on Corbin. So it's just like, I don't get it anymore. I really don't get it. That one was okay. I really love the women's Rumble match. The women's Royal Rumble match was really good.
All right, we're going to talk about it.
I liked it. I my one gripe is I think Alexa Bliss should have stayed in longer. I think she was out, what, number like 15 or something like that. She wasn't... She went out not early, but she didn't go out late. She should have been like one of the last people in there, and she wasn't. And Bianca was good.
You just loved the Nikki Storm thing.
What?
You just loved Nikki Storm. Why did I say
Tony
Nikki Storm?
Storm?
I mean Nikki Cross. Sorry, Nikki Cross. I got crossed up.
No,
Nikki Storm actually works better.
I got crossed up. Lord. No, but you know.
Wait a minute. Huh? What was it?
Well, that, I mean, you're booing yourself there. But, no, I mean, I thought the Rumble was good. The Women's Royal Rumble. A few of the other matches on there, if you guys didn't see it, they had women's match, women's title match for SmackDown, Bayley versus...
Did you just skip over the whole Women's Rumble?
Oh, are we gonna keep going with that?
You were talking about it.
Well, I mean, it was okay. I mean, there was a few entries in there, a few surprises. Mighty Molly was in there. You had I don't even remember any of the Kelly.
Before that, let me mention two things. On the kickoff, you had Sheamus versus Shorty G, which I was on QCB show and told him it was gonna be a joke of a match, and it was. You had Korea versus Andre before he got suspended. Andre won. And then we had the King Reigns versus Corbin. But look at the Women's Warrior Rumble. I mean, man, you had Alexa Bliss, you said she went longer. Bianca was number two.
Mm-hmm.
And then we had Bliss and Cross work together. And then we had Lana came in next, which she's coming in now.
Yeah.
After this was Mercedes Martinez. If you don't know who she is, she was on the Mae Young Classic, and she's an independent wrestler. She's pretty good. She's good.
Yeah.
Then we had Liv Morgan come in, because you knew Liv Morgan was going to go against Lana.
Yeah.
So, and Mandy Rose was number eight. Her and the thing with Otis was funny. That was a highlight of the match.
Thing!
Yeah, we...
It's romance!
Like, go ahead.
What?
It's no
good. It's romance. Well, no, you know, I have a problem with this storyline, and we'll get to it later. WWE, look, as a fat man, stop giving us hope, all right? The fat man does not end up with the very attractive God's greatest invention.
Goddess.
No, it's God's greatest invention. I don't even know what it is. But can you stop making it like, you know, we're gonna end up with the dame? Because it doesn't happen that way. It doesn't. So, you know, WWE, stop giving me hope. Because I don't want your hope. Because it's not real hope. That's all.
Go ahead.
That's all I had.
I thought you had more for that.
Mr. Candlelight, we'll get to that right after end the Women's Royal Rumble talk about Daniel Bryan. He has a question of, was there even a point of Fiend versus Daniel Bryan? We'll get to that.
Yeah, remember that question.
Yeah, I will.
All
right. Just save it. Yeah. Come on, man. Come on.
Listen, fat guys have a chance.
No, we don't.
Yes, you do.
We don't have a chance.
Let me give you an example.
What?
Fred Flintstone had Wilma.
You're giving me a cartoon character? Wow. You just compared me to a cartoon character. You feel good about yourself?
I do, actually.
You feel good? Because guess what? Cartoon character. Wow. Hey, guys. I'm going to end up like Fred Flintstone. Woo!
Ralph Cramden. I had Audrey Meadows on the TV show. Is a fat guy and wife.
What TV show?
Honeymooners.
Don't you dare.
Oh, there we go. Kevin James. Come on. The King of Queens.
This is New York. I mean, She was bound to end up with someone, okay? We're not giving that. Next, you're going to say Mike and Molly, and don't even.
Jason Alexander. Fat guy. He's got a hot wife.
Jason Alexander.
Hey, Drew Carey. Drew Carey had a chance.
Drew Carey's a shapeshifter, okay? He's like, one week he's fat, and now he's skinny. Like, he's just, it's weird.
Peter Griffin.
Again, another cartoon character. Stop it. Stop with the cartoon characters.
Bart Simpson. I mean.
But he's not fat.
Homer.
You mean Homer Simpson? Homer. He wasn't fat when he met her. God. All right, let's get through this one.
I'll try to give you some examples. I'll try to give you hope.
No, you don't give me hope. I don't want the hope.
I mean, this is a horrible example.
I don't want the hope.
Homer Simpson.
Done with the hope.
Yeah, I don't blame you. You should be.
So, thanks. All right. That's great.
Let's go. The rest of the Rumble, right? Since you want to talk about Kerry Zane, me, you know, I'm not going to go person by person.
No.
Tamina was a surprise that she came back. Chelsea Green, I was disappointed she got winning that so quickly. Yeah. Robert Stone's the manager. In case you don't know who that is, it's Robbie E. Charlotte Flair came in at 17. Beth Phoenix, Toni Storm. Man, we love Toni Storm. Bel Air, Bianca ended at 33 minutes. 32
yeah,
and half.
She threw out six people, which I think is the most right now in the Rumble.
Selena Vega.
Oh, I'm sorry, Shayna did too.
Shotzi Blackheart. Ugh. She's new signee to NXT. She's actually pretty good.
She actually is. Yeah, I like her. Yeah.
Tegan Knox, 28. Then we got Santina Marella. All right, listen.
Santina.
I said
get
Santina.
Get her right.
I said Santina. We talked about it earlier. State of Wrestling. What the hell are you doing with Santina in the match? I mean.
It's all right. It's whatever.
You waste a spot. I hate wasting.
All right, who would you want to see?
Who was not in the Rumble?
There's a lot in the Rumble, but I wouldn't.
No, I'm trying to think who was not in the Rumble.
Yeah.
Candice LeRae was in it. Tegan Knox was in it. Dakota Kai. I really seen Dakota Kai in the Rumble. I mean, honestly, I really seen her. Where's the Iconics? I really see one of them in it.
I mean, I
really see Charlie in the Rumble. I really see her in the Rumble. Mm-hmm. I really see her everywhere, but she definitely should be in the Rumble. Mm-hmm. Come on, man.
It's a comedy spot, man.
And then Shayna Baszler came in at 30, and Charlotte Flair won the Rumble.
Yep.
So, but like you said, I thought it was a good Rumble.
It was all right. I mean, it wasn't a bad Rumble. That's what I'm saying. Like, for the last few years, it was probably one of our best ones.
The whole thing, the whole event, and we'll talk about it here in a second. Women's Championship SmackDown's match, Lacey Evans and Bayley.
Yeah. Bathroom break. It was okay. It was just, look, I told you this. I can't. Lacey Evans is not ready for the main event yet. I think she's good. Give her time. Because that's my problem, is I think they pushed her too quick. They pushed her way too quick because she had those matches with Becky, and then all of a sudden, like, they thought she was ready. She was not ready. She's not ready at all.
You got to put her against somebody that has a little bit more charisma. And to me, Bayley is still working on that. Like, it's like, okay, wake me up when you're done, Bayley.
I don't even think it's the charisma thing.
It might be the guy's haircut she's got.
Oh, stop it. It's not a guy's haircut. It's Karen. No, it's the problem is, though, is like her look, she is an incredible athlete, but her ring work is still rust. Like, you can tell, or not rust, but she's just not. You can tell she's still green. She's very green for a wrestler. Like no, Lacey. Lacey's still very great. That's what I'm saying. Like, you should have put her
but like
with
Becky,
someone else.
Becky or Charlotte could have made that a lot better match. Or robbery, I think.
So what? I'd still be complaining about Lacey because I don't like it because the problem is it, okay, but that's like going back and saying Flair put everyone over. Flair could make Joe Smo a star.
Joe
that's
Smo?
True.
Joe Schmo was a star back in the 50s.
Why do you, like, I'm having great points, and you just gotta, you just derail. Here's the train.
Oh, sorry, I'll turn my mic
off. That's not what I said. Have a conversation with me.
I was talking about Joe Schmo.
No, you had to go and talk about Joe Schmo. No, but you know what I mean. Like, that's my only thing with Lacey Evans. I think she's great, but the problem is I think they're pushing her towards WrestleMania, and I don't think she's there yet. Okay. I don't think she's there yet.
No, she's not. But, you know, you're only as good as your dance partner. I'm just saying, like, Becky and Charlotte's got a little bit more charisma.
Well, but we've said that a lot about a lot of wrestlers in the past that are great, but they can't carry, they can only carry certain people.
I don't think Bayley can carry certain people.
Yeah. But I think
Bayley is on that level, the other two, to carry somebody else.
I agree, but I think she's learning. I think that comes with time, too. So, I mean, that's the thing. Like,
she's
a
manager.
I don't know who her opponent will be at SmackDown, but it needs to be somebody big.
She needs to be managed by Robert Snow. Then she doesn't have to talk a lot.
Well, even with this character, she doesn't need to talk a lot because she's that brooding character. Like, I hate everybody now. But she should. I do agree. I think a character would be kind of, or a manager would be kind of cool.
Then we had the strap match for Universal Championship, Daniel Bryan versus The Fiend. We'll talk about that now. Listen, I thought it was a great match. I loved these two when they were together. It was a really good match. And it's perfect for him, for The Fiend and Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan can work with pretty much anybody. And I'm so glad that he's back to this American Dragon thing that he does in the other one he was at.
You mean the S-Man?
Yeah. Of course, The Fiend ended up winning the match. Wow, even Bleacher Report gave it A+. I thought it was a great match. Where are they going with this match? Kendall Light was asking. Listen, it's done, I think, now. What The Fiend is doing, he's going through everybody that beat him in his past. And that's what he should do.
Yeah.
We were watching the Rumble together, and I think the best thing for them to do was to go against the Cena, go against the Undertaker, because that's who he needs to beat. Go against Roman Reigns. He's got to beat Roman Reigns at a pay-per-view. All the guys that have beat him in the past is what he cannot lose at WrestleMania, by the way.
You know?
No matter who he fights, he can't lose at Mania.
No, you're right. You're right. Absolutely. Because we talked about that. That's his one place he has not won yet. And the thing is, you can build up The Fiend for the rest of the year. If he loses at WrestleMania, I think that takes all credibility away from him. Because that's the one place for the last, like 4 or 5 years since Cena beat him at WrestleMania. He's never had a WrestleMania.
He's not had a moment.
He's not had that moment. You're right. I mean, that year when he had the belt against Orton, he should have never lost.
Exactly, because he just won it at
Absolutely, and that's what I'm saying. So I don't understand why. I mean, because I think finally WWE is understanding, okay, we got to strike the iron while it's hot right now because this is good. But I'm just afraid, dude. I'm really afraid at WrestleMania it's gonna be Daniel Bryan's WrestleMania moment. It's either gonna be John Cena's WrestleMania moment. I know, but I'm afraid they're gonna give it back. I just don't see them. Again, I didn't think it was Kofi either. I didn't think Kofi was gonna get that moment at WrestleMania. So maybe we'll see The Fiend get that moment at WrestleMania. But he's gotta go against somebody other than Bryan. So I agree with you that I hope that this is over right now.
Right.
Because he needs to go against someone else. And he can always go against Daniel Bryan down the road. There's no problem with that.
At Mania, it should be him, Roman Reigns, Undertaker, John Cena. Because it's the three people he's got left that he's got to beat.
Oh, God. Don't say that, Mr. Candlelight.
What?
Do you think it'll be Fiend versus Goldberg and lose the title like Owens?
No. I think what they'll do with Goldberg, and we'll talk about it in the next segment, is they'll put him with somebody like Dolph Ziggler at the Super Showdown. Because that's the reason he's coming back.
Yeah, but, hey, Mr. Kennelly, you can call that Fiend versus Reigns at WrestleMania. That's great. I don't mind it. My problem is,
if Fiend wins,
I just don't see him beating Reigns. It's like the whole thing with who won at the Rumble.
That's the reason
I don't see it.
That's the reason I don't think you put Reigns in this match yet. I think you wait until after the Rumble.
Yeah.
Or after WrestleMania.
To be honest with you, I think you build it up to SummerSlam. You have him kind of reign for all this time.
You have Reigns.
And he loses it at SummerSlam. Right. And I think that's perfect.
Yeah, I'm fine with it.
Yeah.
Real fast and Raw, women's title. You had Becky Lynch, Asuka. Had to happen. I thought it was a great match. Once again, Lynch wins. This is dumb. We'll talk about this later. Then you had the men's Warrior Rumble. Real fast, the surprises. John Morrison came back. I thought he was quick, eliminated too quickly. Eric Rowan at number three. Of course, you had Lesnar, number one. Shelton Benjamin, MVP, came back. Keith Lee, Braun Strowman came back. We thought that was going to last a while. It did not. Drew McIntyre was number 16. AJ Styles got hurt. Matt Riddle came in at 23. Reigns came in at 26. Kevin Owens at 27. Aleister Black, Samoa Joe, and Seth Rollins to finish it out. And Edge was the big return.
Yep.
Though. The last two in the match was Reigns and McIntyre. And McIntyre ends up winning the Rumble.
I mean, let's be honest. We talked about it. And like I said, because I didn't want to get into it until we reviewed it a little. The match was great. The second part of the match was great. The first part of the match, was where Lesnar only dominated. And what did I tell you every time Lesnar was in the ring? He was not in the ring with more than three people or two people at a time. So there was only three people in the ring at one time while Lesnar was still in there. That was bad. But after Lesnar got eliminated, I loved the match. Thought the match was great. I think some of the surprises should have came out a little later because of Lesnar. I didn't like the point of them getting thrown out by Lesnar. I thought that was stupid. Because I get what you're doing. You're trying to make him the dominant guy. But this is what I have a problem with Drew McIntyre. I have a problem because you're going to make me think that this guy can beat Brock Lesnar, that only two people in that company right now, well, two people on the main roster have beaten, and that is Seth Rollins and Roman Reigns. Unless you put Drew McIntyre on that same level right now, I don't see him beating them.
Well, when we come back from break, I will tell you why I think Drew McIntyre can win. At Mania, do I think he will? That's a different story.
Yeah.
But you're listening to the rest of the attitude. You got any more questions during the break? You know, ask us. Little Steven is on. Write it down, and we'll make sure we talk about it.
I won't, but okay.
You're listening to Wrestling with Attitude.
You think you know me?
Oh. You right there?
Yeah. How much longer do you want to
have? It's 7 o'clock.
You want to do it 30 more minutes?
That's fine.
Because we can plow through it. Like, I'll just let you go through it. Yeah. Well, I mean, but we got through a lot because you knew we were going to talk about the Rumble that much.
The one I want to talk about the most is the Hall of Fame. I've got about 7 names I want to talk about.
Okay.
And that's it.
You want to talk about? Okay. The Hall of Fame?
Yeah.
Okay.
There should be some new names coming this week.
Yeah, I hope the one I saw was fake, but I don't know for a fact. The whole Alicia thing.
Alicia Fox? Yeah.
ESPN reported it, dude.
I haven't seen that at all.
I think you have a card quick.
Okay.
Get a drink. Is it
unlocked? It's locked. Just push the door all the way open and it'll stay open.
Oh, it'll stay open? Okay.
As you push it, if you push all the way open, it'll stay open. We are back. got to have questions coming.
I've only got like 2 or 3 points I really want to make, so I'm cool, dude.
I'm trying to share
You know?
What you got here?
Now, Mr. Candle, I agree with you. He said, you know, you remember the days when there when we would get surprise returns without spoilers. I agree. But you know what? It's Edge's fault. Because he put that stuff on Twitter himself. He put that picture either on Instagram or Twitter of him looking at his suitcase with his ring gear in it. So he did that himself. But I do agree. I think it would have been better if we didn't know he was coming back. But some people actually didn't know he was coming back.
So, I didn't know.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, I think it was the better of the surprises, though. I think it was a better surprise. Like, it wasn't like when we knew, who was it? Like, a year or two ago, we knew they were coming back. And we were like, oh, no. It's like whenever, like, Brock Lesnar comes back and everything, they have to, like, promote it instead of making it a surprise. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, we don't see that. So, all right.
Ready?
Yeah, that's my thing. Sorry. You alright?
Yeah, I didn't stop this yet.
No worries.
I mean, save it.
And how you doing? It's all about the game.
Oh, I miss you doing this.
Motorhead. Yes, yes, Mr. Candlelight, AJ Styles. You're right, but there's the thing. We knew he was coming, but nobody believed it, you know? Same thing with the Hardys when they came back at WrestleMania. And we knew about it, but nobody knew it was going to happen.
Here's the other problem with that, though, is... No, the Hardys, we didn't know at WrestleMania.
Well, people knew that
there wasn't a lot.
No, but they knew the contract was ending, but we didn't know they were going to come out during the tag team match.
We didn't think that was possible. No, we didn't know they were coming out. I remember us being together. No one in that
room. Oh, yeah, no. I never said, oh, yeah, the Hardy Boys are coming back tonight. I never knew they were coming back or winning that title. You're right. I never knew that at all. I was like, whoa. But what I'm saying is kind of like that. I'm mentioning that with the AJ Styles thing. I didn't think AJ Styles was coming.
The ones that do the best job of it is Jericho, AJ Styles.
Yeah.
But you got to remember, the other problem is NXT now. And you got so many other wrestling platforms, it's not really a surprise. Like, to me, Dean Ambrose showing up at AEW was a complete shocker. Because I didn't think he would leave in WWE.
Well, no one, yeah.
But,
all right,
let's get back into it.
Yeah,
but
there she is. Mr. Candlelight, do you know her? Because she's from England. You all know each other, right?
Welcome back to Wrestling with Attitude on Stitcher, Spreaker, iTunes, iHeart, audio books, Audible, Anchor FM.
Hello?
Yes, it's on.
Son?
It's
okay.
On.
Okay.
Is it on? Break it. All right. So, but yes, I'm sure Mr. Candlelight is next door neighbors of Tony Storm.
I would. If I was him, I'd find the address, but that's just me.
Yes. Oh my God, Creeper. Here we go. Steven the Creeper is coming back.
Well, first off, we're coming back. Hey, when did that ever happen?
You ain't left, huh?
I've only talked about like two girls on this show, and that's Bailey? Okay, sorry. Not girls, excuse me, women, because that's just wrong.
You mean Aunt Karen?
Women. Yeah, I love Aunt Karen and her 700 cats. It's fine. Mr. Candle, I says, yeah, she's my cousin. He gave me the number one, by the way.
Which one?
He told me he was number, that I'm number one. So, she's my cousin. What? I thought, you know, I mean, you guys gotta look alike.
They share
know?
Crumpets.
Yeah.
They share crumpets together.
I mean, kudos to your cousin. I just want to say that.
Beth Phoenix was a surprise as well. I mean, I forgot Beth Phoenix and Edge coming back.
So I know we're going to talk about this in this segment with Mr. Camelot actually asking, can we discuss Orton versus Edge and do we need it because can you see a outcome afterwards? We will discuss
that. We'll do it right here in a second because we're getting ready to talk about Raw.
Mm-hmm.
But I wanted to also mention, we are sponsored by Attitude Broadcasting. We put attitude in broadcasting. The ABC 2020. Hey, you get it? ABC 2020? No?
I mean, I've heard it so many times, and we're just in February. I'm sorry.
I know, but ABC.
Are you Barbara? Are you Barbara?
Yes, I'm Barbara Walters.
This is Barbara Walters, and this is. I don't understand what you want.
Diane Sawyer. Welcome to our show.
Diane Sawyer. Lord.
Anyway, moving on from that. You can catch all our shows, of course, on WrestlingAttitude.com or Spreaker.
Yes, Spreaker.
Or Anchor FM or any of those great platforms.
Anchor FM.
Don't forget to listen and watch live on Facebook Live BSS Carolinas every Saturday at 10 a.m.
I know that guy.
So
Harry's cool.
Yeah, Rocky Summer. He's a really good guy.
Yeah. Oh, I was talking about the...
other guys?
Yeah.
V3's a good guy. All right, let's get into some Raw... No, we're going to do... Yeah, we'll do Raw review. We'll do the Hall of Fame after.
Sure.
We so, Raw this week, of course, it opened up with Mr. I get all this written down. Of course, it opened up with the Randy Orton thing this week. Kendra like was wanting to talk about it, so we'll talk about it a little bit. Orton comes out, he doesn't say anything really, except that, oh my god, the electricity in that arena.
I loved it. It was awesome. Yeah.
And so, you know, show what Orton did to Edge. I love it. I mean, what's the problem with Orton and Edge? I mean, to me, here's the thing. Orton is the best. It reminds me of when Orton did this, the Triple H back in the day, and they main event. It was a main event at WrestleMania, and it's personal, and it's really. I mean, and the way he did this, he didn't say anything. He said, "I can't do this," and he walked out.
So, my one thing is
your one big thing.
Yes. I agree with, well, not agree with Mr. Candlelight, but it's the question I have too. What is the outcome? Because I just feel this is a one-off. You know, and are we okay with that? Because this is something I could actually see for a few months if we really wanted to.
But, now, when you say one-off, what do you mean? One-off until Super Showdown?
No, I mean, I just think this is going to be him versus, it's just WrestleMania and that's it.
For Edge?
Yeah. No, not for Edge. For Edge and Orton. This rivalry.
And that's okay. Because think about it. We've seen... Who else have we seen had this kind of... Daniel Bryan and The Miz has had the same type of thing.
Yeah.
Right, where they would go... They had two matches and then they killed it for 6 months. Then they did it again.
True.
So why not... You could do until WrestleMania.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, they'll build a story up. Because to me... What this is going to do is build a story up to WrestleMania.
Yeah.
Which I think is great. And I still don't buy that this was supposed to be Orton versus Edge all along. I still think this was going to be AJ Styles versus Edge.
Yeah.
And AJ Styles got hurt. And I think they had to do a switcheroo. And I think that's what they came up with, Edge and Orton. Which is great because Orton is a great bad guy.
Well, Mr. Candlelight is weighing in here and saying, we all know the buildup of this will be mic talks and sneak attacks. Yeah, but what else are you going to do?
Right.
I mean, look, I mean, even in Orton's, even with Orton, what are you going to do with Orton? You can't keep him wrestling every week.
I know what you need to do.
What?
You need to have Orton show up to NXT 1 week and RKO Beth. Make it really personal. Because what made Triple H and Randy great? He RKO'd his Steph. Make it personal. I know we've seen it before, but hell, I'm seeing the same thing on AEW and Monday Night Raw and SmackDown. I see some of these same storylines again. But when Randy Orton is the bad guy, he's one of the best. I mean,
I'm not doing this to pander to you, but have Christian show up and do his talk show one week. To talk about it.
I got one better. Have Randy Orton on backstage 1 week and RKO on backstage.
Yeah, you could do that.
Why not?
Yeah. I mean, There's a lot you could do with it. I don't know. I mean, I do think it's a good build-up, but the problem is, Orton could bring him out, could bring out Christian and beat him up. You're right. That could happen. You're right, Mr. Cadillac. But my only thing is, it's kind of like with the whole Triple H and Batista. I wanted to see more of that. But because we knew it was a one-off.
Because he's a Hall of Fame.
That's what I was, that's what I'm afraid of with Edge, of that we know it's going to be a one-off. I want to see more to it, because I think we're going to see so much from this build-up that we're gonna be left wanting more.
Well, I think you'll see more. If you're saying more Edge, I think you'll see more of Edge.
Yeah.
I think he's around for a year.
Oh, no. Spoiler alert to anyone that doesn't know. He signed a 3-year contract with WWE. So,
that's the reason. I think he'll be around for a year, if not longer.
Okay.
I'm just saying, I think at least until next WrestleMania.
Yeah.
If he could go 3 more years, fine.
Yeah.
I mean, who knows? He might. I think he's going to be hit and miss. Take a couple weeks off, this and that. And that's fine. But how many. And I saw a complaint of somebody talking about Randy Orton isn't one of the top 10 wrestlers of all time. Or one of the best. And maybe it's something we need to debate 1 week. But how many times has Randy Orton took a match like this? I mean, he did the same thing with AJ Styles. He did the same thing with CM Punk. You know, WrestleMania. It was supposed to be a throwaway match and made it a great match. He had a match with the other two of Legacy at a Mania match and made it a good match. Okay, we ain't gonna talk about Batista and that mess up they had, but that wasn't all him.
Yeah, but that was different. So, but yeah, I mean, I've never really debated that. I mean, I think Orton is one of the top 10 wrestlers. I don't know if because if I'm gonna count Cena of all time, I'll count him, because they should both be in that class. I do. Because they both really, for almost, well, not 20 years, but for at least 12 or so years, they paved the way of that 2004 to 2014. They were kind of the faces in a way. They were.
They have been. I'm just saying, he's taken mush and turned it into gold.
Yeah.
Of his stuff he's done.
Yeah.
You know, back to Raw for a minute. Lana versus Liv Morgan. Liv Morgan wins again. Rude Riot comes out, beats her up. Are you so glad?
I'll wake up later.
Mojo Riley versus Drew McIntyre. 2-second match.
That's my buddy.
24/7. You were partying with him. Kevin Owens and the Viking Raiders versus Buddy Murphy, AOP. I guess it was an elimination match. Buddy and AOP win. Mm-hmm. Aleister Black versus Eric Young. Poor Eric Young. I don't know what to say about Eric Young. Rey Mysterio versus Angel Garza. Garza DDTs Rey Mysterio. Supposedly Rey Mysterio failed the drug test. I don't know if that's true. Charlotte Flair announcement she's going to show up on NXT because Ripley came out. Asuka versus Natalya. Wake me up when that match is over. Becky comes out. And then we had Triple Threat main event. Rollins, Lashley, Ricochet. Ricochet ends up winning the match. Lesnar comes out and F5's Ricochet. Listen, I love Ricochet. He's going to make. Do you know how many German suplexes he's going to take? He'll probably take 15 to 20. And he can go. Back to, this is at Super Showdown, so I'm not looking for a 5-star match anyway, that show.
Yeah. I mean, at least I thought if Rollins was going to win, we could have saw something of Rollins maybe taking the belt from Lesnar.
But why do we need it?
I'd rather see Lesnar versus Drew McIntyre than Drew McIntyre versus Lesnar. I don't need to see Lesnar in the main event anymore. I don't need to see him with that title anymore. I don't get the point why he's the guy you got to prove that you can beat. when he doesn't really do any pay-per-views. Like, he does 2-3 pay-per-views a year. I just don't see the point of him being the standard. He is the standard right now in WWE, and it's wrong.
He had a good Royal Rumble, actually, even though he looked
out of shape.
But I'm okay with it. What we were talking about, I mean, kind of like asked about Drew McIntyre and Lesnar. I love it.
Yeah.
Because Drew McIntyre has a chance.
Yeah.
It's one word. Claymore.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, he hits him once with Claymore, he could win the match. I don't think he will, but he could. Because Lesnar's lost what now? Last two Manias?
Yeah.
No, last year. That's it so far.
Yeah.
So is he going to lose this one? I would be okay if he does, but is he?
I don't think so. That's the thing. Because trust me, I love McIntyre, and I think McIntyre is on, like you and I were talking about before the break, I do believe he is on that level of Rollins and Reigns. I just don't think WWE believes he is on that level because, yes, he's a main eventer and everything.
He's got a main event mania. But
the way that they're doing with Lesnar, because I've noticed this, they're giving other people. You didn't even let Strowman beat Lesnar, the guy that should have beat Lesnar.
Yeah, but they wanted to show that McIntyre was. And don't forget, Ricochet did do something that match.
Oh, yeah, no, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that it's just. Like, I'm getting tired of. Like, Lesnar right now is the bar, and I don't understand why.
No, actually, he's not the bar.
It's not Cesaro and Sheamus.
They're the bar. But we'll see where it goes. I think McIntyre's got a good chance of winning. I don't think he will. But I love that the build-up, they've got a couple months before Mania to make it believable that McIntyre could win.
Yeah, okay, three things here. Mr. Candlelight, I guess you're just the third part of the show here.
Ain't that like that?
Christian is better than Orton, JK. Aleister Black, why is he being used so poorly? We'll get to that in a second. And also, McIntyre's going to win at Mania since Lesnar sends Lesnar away for a month, comes back, takes the title. I want to get to that first before we get to the Aleister Black thing. But here's the thing. We see this all the time. That's my problem. Why does Lesnar have to go away? Why can't we just have Lesnar do other things that doesn't have to have him have a belt on him? That's what gets on my nerves. Like, when he came back against Cena back in 2013, he didn't wrestle much in 2013. But you know what happened every time he did? He impacted. There was a reason he came back. And he didn't have the title. So I'm okay with that. So why do we need him coming back and taking the title? That's what I have a problem with. Like, I don't understand, like, why. I get Vince must like him, but he's not the only one that can put butts in seats.
Listen, I agree, but I disagree to this point. You got to remember, when he won the title,
Yeah.
He won the title by beating Kofi.
Yes. Okay. Yeah.
When they went to Fox. Mm-hmm. Fox has paid $5 million for WWE SmackDown to be on Fox.
Yes.
Guess who? What they're going to do? Lesnar's going to win that title, which he did. And I he's actually been here more now than he's ever been on Raw before.
Yeah, but he's wrestled less.
He's been on TV at least.
Yeah.
At least he's been there.
Yeah.
Years past, he didn't show up. Now. But,
yeah.
He put over Drew McIntyre at least. You know, he got eliminated in the Rumble by McIntyre. Okay? And there's a lot of people, including myself, that thought he would go the distance and win the whole thing.
Yeah. No, I agree.
At least he got eliminated. And he let Ricochet kick him in the,
Yeah.
So, I mean, in years past, that probably wouldn't have happened.
I know, but that's the thing.
That's a win. Rollins beat him at Mania last year for the title. I mean, come on. What else you want to do?
And beat him at SmackDown. Or, SummerSlam.
Right.
Not SmackDown.
But he beat him twice this year.
No, and that's great.
And we're like, that's not gonna happen.
No, I'm that's not it. I'm just going off a doubt because, you know, it's the whole Kofi thing. I still got a bad taste in my mouth from the Kofi thing. And I just don't think that Drew McIntyre is going to beat him. Now, if he does, great. I want to be proven wrong. I do. I just don't know if it's going to happen. Because I don't know what they want to do. Because here's the other thing. McIntyre's on Raw, correct?
Yes.
Here's the other thing. They want to keep that title on SmackDown for some weird reason. I don't know why. By the way, both titles are on SmackDown, which that's another discussion for another day.
Some Raw.
Well, no, because...
Universal title. Lesnar's on Raw.
Yeah, that's not the Universal title. That's the regular title.
Right, dude. Yes, he's on Raw.
I thought he's on SmackDown still.
No, he's on Raw. He's been shown on Raw. He ain't been shown on SmackDown.
Well, I mean, he took the title from Kofi and he stayed on SmackDown. That's why it confused me. But anyways, I don't care about that. But my whole thing is, yes, but if he wins it, I think he'll still go to Fox because Fox still wants him. They have a contract with him to show up on SmackDown. They want him on SmackDown. That's the whole point.
No, but he's not on SmackDown because they put The Fiend on SmackDown.
Yeah, I think they're both there, man.
No, they're not. You remember he said, I quit SmackDown.
When did he do that?
A while back.
I don't remember.
And as I was getting to say, all fairy tales come to an end.
Oh my God. Okay? Shut up.
Cinderella ends
at midnight. Shut up. She doesn't end it. Oh my God. He doesn't end at midnight.
It ends at midnight. Moving back on to our...
By the way, so 2018 was your rants, right? R.I.P.
Yep.
is what Mr. Candlelight said, because now 2020 is the year of Steven rants.
They haven't ended, in case you don't know. What was his other question you were going to...
Aleister Black. Yeah, let's talk about
Aleister
that.
Aleister Black, listen. Yeah. I love that Buddy Murphy is getting a push. But what are you going to do with Aleister Black right now? I mean, what are you going to do? Where's the U.S. Championship? Oh, yeah, that's Andre, you know, is fighting.
Actually, that's where he needs to go. He needs to go against Andrea.
Not yet.
Andrade.
Not yet.
Why would you say Andrea? It's Andrade.
Mrs. Flair.
Stop it.
Mrs. David Flair. I was going to say that.
Wow, she is there.
No, you need to have him in a good story. He had the Buddy Murphy thing. He needs to go against a legitimate guy.
Yeah.
Now he's, because he helped put over Murphy. Now, if you put him like a guy against Ricochet, after Ricochet loses, maybe, let them have great matches, because they don't have great matches. Stop giving him Eric Young for 3 seconds, or EC3, or whoever who else they
want. Well, but they always do this with guys they don't want to like. You know, they don't want to completely hurt their characters, so they give them squash matches. And I hate when they do that. You know I've talked about that. I want to see them in rivalries. I would rather see you in a rivalry than a squash match with somebody. But I don't know. I mean, I don't think Aleister Black is done yet. I think you're just waiting.
Oh, no.
I mean, just, like, give it. I mean, maybe after WrestleMania he'll get a push for something. Hopefully the U.S. title, because I think he'd be perfect in that picture right now. If you move on, I really do.
I wouldn't do it yet, but yeah.
No, I'm saying after Mania, though. After Mania, I think he'd be a perfect person to go up against whoever wins, if it is Andrade, which it should be, because they had some really good matches in NXT. I think that'd be great.
Right. All right, let's move on. Let's preview a little bit so we can wrap up.
Yeah.
This week on TNT, AEW Dynamite, you got Cody versus... That's not true.
That's the best preview I've ever heard you say. That's not true.
No, it's not. I was looking up AEW preview for this week, but that was the wrong one. You had Jon Moxley, of course, is now the number one contender.
Mr. Eye Patch.
Yeah. This week, Cody Rhodes is getting 10 lashes on TV by MJF. By the way, I love
why 10
MJF
lashes?
Is great. Well, it's one of the old school things. Jon Moxley's going up against Ortiz. Listen, LAX was great on Impact, not here. 10 Lashes on live TV is great. Young Bucks, Omega, and Paige against the Lucha Brothers, The Butcher, and Blade. I love The Butcher and Blade. I don't like Blade because he looks like old Arn Ole Anderson, 1950.
Yeah, he does. He does look weird.
And that's it. So that's this week's AEW. All
right. Well, I'm looking forward to that.
I am. NXT this week, of course, you'll have Charlotte appearing.
Uh-huh.
So we'll see what happens with that.
All right. Yeah, no, okay. So one last thing. I know we got to wrap up here because we still got a bunch to talk about. I'm excited for this. I really am. I'm really excited about Charlotte Flair going to NXT. If this does happen, I want to see this match at Mania because this is the match, I think. I think, like, yeah, you could put her against Becky. You could put her against Bayley. What's the point? Have her go on NXT. You keep talking about you want NXT to be your third brand, not the minor leagues anymore. Well, guess what? This is how you do it. And hopefully, this is a gateway for other wrestlers to go down to NXT. And what I mean by that, I want to see Roman down there. I want to see Bray, I'd love to see The Fiend down there. I'd love to see Daniel Bryan down there. I want to see Seth Rollins down there. I want to see these guys compete for the NXT championship just like anyone else would. Like, I don't think it needs to be the minor leagues anymore. It doesn't. And it's starting to be better. So hopefully, if Charlotte does go against her, hopefully this puts NXT on the map where we don't have, like, I like the takeovers, but I think the main championships should be on WrestleMania, not on the takeovers.
I agree.
So that's my one take with it. Yeah, I mean, I think it's great, and I'm okay with her winning if it does mean if it means a match at WrestleMania. Now, if they don't put that match on WrestleMania and they put it on takeover,
oh no, then it will be on.
Oh no, I hope, but I'm just saying.
And I'm good with that.
Yeah,
because she's proved herself, and of course, yes. I think you'll end up seeing Shayna against Becky.
Yeah,
which I think will be great.
Yeah.
So, let's get into the Hall of Fame stuff real fast.
Yeah.
SmackDown, of course, this week Goldberg will be on it, so we'll see what happens there. The 2020 Hall of Fame, NWO has already been confirmed with Hogan, Scott Hall, Kevin Nash, not Sean Waltman, six. Okay. So he's going to be a two-time Hall of Fame induction. Batista's being already going to.
Wait, what?
Yeah,
Batista. Whoa, didn't hear about this.
Who will induct the NWO? I think Eric Bischoff is the rumor. Makes sense.
It needs to be Eric. Or, you know what? It'd be a weird one, but I'd be okay with Ted, with DiBiase.
Yeah, you could.
Eric should. Or, I mean, you know, if...
it's got to be Eric.
If billionaire Ted's out there, you know, you could get him too.
Yeah, all right. Batista, of course, said he wants Finley to induct him, which makes total sense.
Why?
He trained him. And
I didn't actually
He
know
was
that.
On SmackDown during that time. Like, he really helped Batista. Like,
I would think Triple H or...
No, he wants Fit Finley. What?
Dennis Rodman and the NWO. I agree. Carl Malone. Yeah, Carl Malone.
He delivers.
Yeah. Hey, you know, maybe Devon, you know? Gave him his first start there.
No. Maybe it'll be Dana Brooke. She delivers.
Oh my god.
I heard she delivers.
See, I already said that, Mr. Candlelight. Like, don't even. why not Devon Dudley?
Okay. Some of the predictions, y'all can say yay or nay. Vader. I think it's time for Vader.
Vader's not in yet?
No.
Lord, Vader should have been. Wow. Yes.
Okay. Mick Foley would seem like it would be a good choice to induct him, which I agree with. Mick Foley.
Mick Foley's already in.
No, inducting him.
Oh, inducting who?
Vader.
Oh, wow.
Captain Shack inducting Vader, it makes sense.
Either him or I mean, he did take his ear.
Yeah, I mean, he took a lot.
I'm trying to think of anyone. I mean, I guess maybe Shawn Michaels. But
Harley Race can't do it.
Oh, too soon, buddy.
I'm not doing anything wrong. Here's another name, Bruce Pritchard, Brother Love.
Oh, Pritchard would be great, yeah.
Brother Love and Shane McMahon inducts him, or JBL, because they're really close friends.
Oh, he was close friends with Vader?
Yep.
Wow.
No, not Vader. Bruce, Brother Love. Oh, we moved on from Vader.
Okay, you gotta get like...
Bruce yeah. Pritchard.
Okay.
Brother
no,
Love.
I don't need Brother Love.
Brother Love needs to be in the Hall of Fame. Yes, no. Definitely.
It can wait.
Hey, look, Aunt Karen's coming down the ring.
Look, see, she just looks
what
like...
What is that headband? What is she wearing?
She looks like a cat peed on her floor, and now she's got to go battle for her title.
What is she wearing over her head, by the way?
I don't know.
Exactly.
I don't ask.
All right, the next one real fast, Rhea Ripley.
Really?
Yes. Makes sense to me. He should be in there, definitely.
I'd rather see Steven Ripley. Also, if he does go in, I think Stone Cold would be a great in because of like the way he kind of helped him pay either him or Triple H, because Triple H has actually even talked about how much Regal actually helped him get in the business. So
I could see Daniel Bryan as well, because he's
you're right, yeah,
winter yep. And his success in wrestling.
Yeah, that makes sense.
But yeah, one of those guys, the celebrity Cyndi Lauper. Is not in the Hall of Fame yet. Sami Zayn says she should be in the Hall of Fame.
Sami Zayn says a lot of things.
If she goes in, I think you have to... I don't know. Heath Slater inducts her. It's probably got to be Zayn. This one will probably happen. The woman that will get in this year will probably be Molly Holly. Because she inducted Ivory a couple years ago.
Molly?
Or last year. Yeah, Molly Holly.
Well, Molly should be in. Yeah. I mean, well...
What, you don't think she should be in?
I don't know, man. Like, it's really hard with those because... Okay. Wait, is Sable already in?
No.
Heck, Sable should be in before her. Sorry.
That's not what happened yet. I think Molly should be in because she helped. She had an impact on the locker room to help.
Yeah, I don't know.
You got another woman to place her with instead of Molly? Who you gonna put in?
We talked about Kelly.
Kelly?
Yeah.
Kelly, not yet, man. Kelly, no. She will at some point. She's too young. She's only 33.
No.
She's probably got, she'll keep coming back at the Rumble for 4 more years. Women, you could do Melina, but you ain't gonna do that.
Nah, I don't do
it. You could do Jillian Hall. No. You talked about it earlier. You said something about Alicia Fox. And for the love of God,
No. I don't want her in. I've just heard some rumors that ESPN put out, hopefully is not true at all, of Alicia Fox getting in to the Hall of Fame. And I don't think she is, but... I think I would have saw something more by now. I don't know. I mean, I guess Molly Holly would be okay. I have no problem with it. It's just... You know, here's the thing. I know he died a really bad... The way he died was tragic. Will we ever see Crash Holly in the Hall of Fame?
For what?
Well, with the whole... Hardcore title and all that. Like, I mean, he did stuff at that time. That's what I'm saying. Like, I understand we don't see him as a trailblazer, but he did stuff. I don't know. I mean, I would rather put Crash in than Bob.
Well, Bob's will never get in, most likely.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
I don't know. I mean, I wouldn't doubt him ever getting in. I don't know. I'm not talking Bob. Crash. But I don't know.
Well, here we saw Miss Elizabeth go in a couple years ago, right? No, we
Miss Elizabeth is still not in.
Miss Elizabeth Lita's in already. Bull Nakano, you know.
Actually, that is one.
China guy in last year.
Heck, if you're going to go her, Bull, I'd go with Goldberg's chick, not Melina. Or not
Goldberg's chick.
No, or not Goldberg's chick, Goldust.
I'm getting there. I haven't gotten there. Give me a sec. Stephanie McMahon,
which
but
one?
She ain't going in yet. Hold on, I'll tell you. Jacqueline went in. Cindy Lauper's not been in. Lunge of Blaze is in. Judy Grable.
Who's that? The cat lady? Who's Judy Grable?
Well, in the world, Barefoot Contessa. Oh my gosh. All right, this is crazy. Luna Vachon.
Barefoot Contessa's on the Food Network. What is
this? Forget it. Luna Vachon is the one you're talking
about. Yes, I want Luna.
Luna should be at some point. But yeah, I'm fine with that.
I don't even think. Is her dad in yet? Did they finally put her dad in?
I don't think so.
I think they did, like, under something 2 years
ago. And then the last one, the grass one of them all, Christian. And, of course, the person that should induct him is Edge. Why not, dude? Why not?
Man, you know how I feel about this. Edge and Christian should have went in together. I said that. And I hate now because I feel it should have been Edge and Christian going in together. Because it made more sense. It made more sense for them two to go together. Sorry, Mr. Candlelight said Nicole Bass. Absolutely.
Beat me.
Hey, stop. Oh, what about the girl in WCW?
Jazz?
No, Major Jugs.
Major Guns.
Stop. Anyways.
Major Jugs.
I said Guns.
Major Nugs.
Yeah, no, that's... That's something else. That's totally different.
That's Wendy's. He gets spicy nugs.
Sure. We said for the celebrity going in, we're thinking Cindy Lauper.
They didn't put one in last year, really.
Who?
They did not put a celebrity in last year.
You're right.
They didn't.
They
so
did
we'll
not.
See. But going back to Edge and Christian, Christian should be in.
Yeah, listen, absolutely.
You already
know
Booker T went in twice.
No, I know.
Ric Flair's twice. We talked about this many times. Like, Ric Flair, Hulk Hogan should be the only ones that have been there.
Yeah, I know.
Maybe Shawn and Triple H. Besides that, everybody else should be once and done.
I just, the only reason Edge went in because they didn't think he was ever going to wrestle again. You know?
And well, he was going to go in anyway.
I know. I would have rather see him go in with Christian. I just thought that tag team was more, I think he was impactful as a singles wrestler, of course, all day long. But I think if you're going to put him in the Hall of Fame, he should go in with Christian. I think it makes more sense for those two to go in together. But if you're going to put Christian in, you should. You should put Christian in. I just would rather see them together. But yeah, we all know who's going to induct Christian. It's Edge. Or no, is it Tyson? They're going to have Tyson induct Christian? We should. Or The Rock, because, you know, they're friends.
Is that true?
Yeah, because he's the peep. He's the peep because he's the people's champ. Remember?
He's the people champ?
Yeah.
All right. Do you have anything else, sir, for the Hall of Fame?
No, I think that's great on the Hall of Fame. I don't know where else they're going to go, man.
We'll see. We got more time, so we'll find out. All right, next week's top five is top returns of all time. All right, that's next week. Today in wrestling history, real fast, in case you didn't know, it is our buddy Eric Adams' birthday yesterday. I tagged him. Puerto Rican line.
I don't care.
Independent scene star.
He didn't wish me a happy birthday, so I don't care.
Right. And it was Kerry Von Erich's birthday yesterday.
Yeah, I actually was on Twitter, and I saw that Jim Ross and a few others actually... tweeted a little bit about that and everything. So that was. And his brother Kevin did as well. So yeah, happy birthday to Kerry. Was that okay? This is a stupid question to ask on air, but was that is he the one that was wrestling mostly in Japan? Was that Kerry or is that Kerry Von Erich or no?
Kerry was which one? Do you remember who Kerry Von Erich?
Was that the
human tornado?
No, the red tornado.
It was no red tornado.
The human? You mean
Texas
the Texas
tornado.
Human tornado! Who's the human? stupid tornado.
He's not a red tornado.
Oh, okay, yeah, because that's worse than a human tornado. What was he, a robot, James? Huh? What was he, a rooster? Was he the red rooster?
They were related. You know what said it. A big red machine. I mean,
yeah, hey, what's wrong with that? Oh, man.
What?
All right, he's going to get your blood boiling. Mr. Candlelight says, I'd rather put Gangrel in over Christian. You know, I do agree, though. If Christian goes in, does the Brood go in?
No.
That is a question.
No.
Why not?
How many times have we won tag titles? Twice, maybe?
As the Brood, yeah.
Twice
or three times before they broke up and went Edge and
Christian. Well, of course, it don't matter. The Bushwhacker got in. They didn't.
Yeah, so put the Brood in. Come on.
Yeah, why not? I mean, we've already talked about the Hall of Fame. Hell, just open the door for everybody.
And yes, Mr. Candlelight, get that on Twitter. I'll follow you on there. Hashtag Human Tornado. That's the thing now. It's a thing. Oh, and hashtag Bione.
If you would go and watch Sharknado, there is a human tornado.
That's what we need to do. After every show, we will have the summits hashtags for the week. And your hashtags will be whatever words you come up with, okay?
All right.
That's going to be your hashtags.
This week's hashtags
are the human tornado and Bione.
Human tornado. And Donnie?
B-E-Y-O-N-E-E. Bione. Like bologna, but without the L. Bione.
There'd be so much bologna. They used to be good in previous life, but they're bologna so bad.
Oh my god. Yes, and you have to use them in sentences. I think this is perfect. We need to do the summits hashtags of the week.
I'm fine with that. We'll do backstage. We'll do that every week. But yeah, that's mainly the big stuff from this day in wrestling history. I'm gonna have to get some more stuff next week. But
well, you know,
birthdays are out there.
Yeah. Well, there wasn't a lot to happen this week in wrestling, you know. It's just February.
It's only February.
Oh, wait. Didn't the Super Bowl thing happen this week, or was that last?
That was last week. That was January 31st when Halftime Heat was.
Ah, okay.
So you almost got it there. So
or first. January 31st?
Yeah. That's it, January 31st. All right. You got anything else for the show?
I'm good.
I, Mr. Canlight, and anybody else out there watching and listening to us, this is our new time, Tuesdays at 7 p.m.? 6 p.m.? 7? 6, 7?
Around 6:30. Here, yeah. Just tune in. 6:45. Just tune in on a Tuesday around 6.
Stay on Twitter.
Like 6:30.
Stay on Twitter at 6:00.
Yeah, keep us.
Keep refreshing.
Yeah, at WWA Show. Just follow us, okay?
All right. Everybody have a great week in wrestling. We'll see y'all next week.
Chosen one.
All right. So, Mr. Candlelight, before we go. Top five words James can give to the Fire Funhouse. Oh, he also did say something earlier that I forgot to bring up. That you should go on the Fire Funhouse, or you should be the host.
Wish I was hosting the Fire Funhouse. The Fire Funhouse. Yeah, I'll do it. I can't.
Why did you have to put more fire up there?
Make it extra exciting.